And now, backstage with Steve Rizzo.
You know, I am often asked the question, Steve, because that's my name, what is the most valuable lesson you've learned about success and happiness? And without any hesitation at all, my response is always, never, ever use your words to describe a challenging situation. Rather, always use your words to change your perspective of a challenging situation. It just makes sense. We need to be really especially careful about the words we speak out loud when things aren't going the way that we want. Yes, it's true that what you think is what you get. But what you say out loud in the midst of troubling times has even greater, much greater impact. Although it may be possible to convince yourself that, you know, you're trying to stay positive when the situation calls for some good old-fashioned angst. But you need to understand that what you say out loud during those tough times will very well make the difference in the long run on how long you remain into that negative situation. The words that you speak amplify your feelings. Those feelings trigger emotions, mental images, which in turn will lead you to the actions that you eventually take. And listen, here's the bottom line. The actions that you take will lead you to the outcome. In other words, if what you think is what you get, then what you say out loud is what you ask for. If you're always thinking about how badly life is treating you and telling who will ever stand long enough to regret doing so about how you just can't get a fair shake and everything is not going the way that you want, you're going to always feel miserable. Always. Think about it. You ever hear anyone say misery loves company? Being miserable, hello, being miserable doesn't exactly attract good things into your life, does it? You have to understand that. If you want your life to change for the better, start by consciously changing what you think and what you say. Awareness is the first step in stifling this voice, or as I like to call it, this big mouth in your head, from turning a compulsively negative mindset around. You see, once you recognize this dismal reality these thoughts and words are creating for yourself, you can step back, observe the direction that you're going in, and take action against them. You see, you do this by counter-attacking with empowering thoughts and words that will instill hope, faith, confidence, courage, determination, and optimism. Whatever it is that's bringing you down, acknowledge the fear, anger, or any negative emotion that it represents, and immediately, when I say immediately, I mean immediately, go on the offensive and bombard those negative emotions with empowering, emotionally charged words. And if you're worried about someone catching you talking to yourself and thinking that you're a nut, it doesn't matter. Just jump in your car, close the windows, take off, and give that big mouth inside of your head a piece of your mind. And I dare you to have fun with this. Have a New York attitude. Hey, I know you're there. And I know what you're trying to do, but it won't work. You want to know why? Because I'm in control here. This is my life. I get to choose what thoughts that flow out of my mind. I get to choose the words that come out of my mouth. But most of all, I have a force, a power in me that is bigger than anything that you can throw at me. You understand what I'm saying here? I'll hit you in the head with a Buick. So go ahead. Hit me with your best shot. One thing is certain. I am going to prevail. See how I had fun there? That's what you need to do. Whether coming from a positive or negative place, your words inevitably affect your attitude, thus your situation. Always remember this. You are the creator of your life. The moment you open up your mouth to say something, you start the process of creation and motion. Listen, the choice is yours, my friend. It always was, and it always will be.